Hey, hello everybody, this is Brahim with another video. I've been learning the Go, aka Go language, for the last week, and I've made this tic-tac-toe come online game as my first project for practicing. First of all, let's talk about the Go language a little bit. So Go is a statically typed, low-level compiled language. It's been created by a team at Google that includes some senior developers that related directly to some big projects like C language and Unix. One of them is Ken Thompson, and that is a really big name, which will make the Go language a big deal. Go language is similar to the C language, but with memory safety and some other features. So yeah, let's have a look on the game now. We're gonna type here in the console to run our game. Gonna type go run the name of our file, which is main go, as you can see, main.go, and there you go. This is the game. It's gonna ask you for position to play. Gonna type the first one, and he places the O, and now it's extern. Gonna choose another cell. We're gonna for this one and for this one. Let's make the O wins. So O, yeah, O is winner. That's the game basically. Now let's have a look on the code. So yeah, this is our code. First of all, we declare the package main, and we import these other packages, error and FMT, which is allow us to print on the screen. We have OS, which is operating system functions, and operating system execute functions, which allow us to execute command line functions. We have this type game struct. It have a board, an array of 9. We have a player string. We have turn number int. And we have our main function. The Go language, every program have only one main function. So first of all, we've made an instance of the game type under the name game with small g, and we initiate the player by x. If we change this into O, it's gonna start with the O player, and we have a game over, a string, boolean take false, and the string winner. We have here a for loop. Something funny about Go language, it has one type of loop, which is for. So we're gonna for while game over is different than true. We're gonna print our board. We're gonna ask the player for a move, and we're gonna play that move and handle the error. If the error is if we have an error, we're gonna print it on the screen, and we break the loop and back. If there is no error, the position is valid and everything is right, we're gonna check for a winner to see if there is a winner or it's a draw. And something else, Go language support double return functions. So here we have a function that return two values, a boolean game over and a string winner. So if the check winner returns the true, it's gonna change the game over value to true, and the for loop is gonna break out, and we're gonna print the board again and check if the winner is empty, it's a draw. Else we're gonna print the winner if it is O or X winner. So yeah, what else? Yeah, Go language is a functional programming language, which means there is no classes or objects. However, you can define methods on type. Like we have here, we have the game. Game is an instance of the game type. But here we said dot play. This is a function. But game type struct that does not have any play function. So how we do this? Let's go to the play function. The play function, or method, sorry, have a an end position argument and return an error type. But here we have this code that tell it is a pointer receiver method. So any game type can access that play method. Like we have here, it's a game type dot play. We can access the play method, but since it is a pointer, a receiver, anything that happen with that game variable is gonna change. Is gonna change it permanently. So yeah, let's have a look on the other function. We have this clear function, clear screen function. It's gonna call the CMD and the clear screen function to clear the screen for us to write the new board. And we have this switch players method. It's a method on the receiver pointer method. It's gonna check if the player is O, it's gonna turn it to X, and else is gonna turn it to O. What else we have? We have ask for player function, it's gonna return an int, and type on the screen enter position to play and read that entered value and return it as an int. We have the print board function. It's gonna take an array of 9 and clear the screen, loop inside that array, break the line each 3 cells to me and print a bar to make it look like a board. What else we have? We have this check for winner function. It's gonna loop inside the array and check if there is a winner horizontally, vertically, or diagonally, and return a true or a false. I think that's it. So yeah, that was it. Maybe I didn't explain it the right way. I'm still learning too. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. I'm gonna leave a link to the GitHub repository down below in the description section. Yeah, thanks for being here. Hit that subscribe button. Until the next time, see you soon.